Coach curve is one of the most commonly used example of the fractal. Fractal is defined as a rough or a fragmented geometric shape that can be subdivided into different parts, and each of which is a reduced size copy of the whole object. Means what the fractal is? Fractal is nothing but, in simple word I can tell you, to describe any object we have some mathematical formula or mathematical representation using which we can represent any object. But if we want to represent any natural object which is there in the nature, that is clouds, trees, lightning, so for this there is no mathematical formula is available. So for such type of cases we have to use the fractals. The word fractal was derived from a Latin word fractus, which means broken. Fractals are complex patterns that are self-similar and therefore exhibits the similar pattern at every scale. It occur very commonly in nature, such as cloud, mountain, trees and snowflakes. Means for such type of objects we can use the fractals. Now, how the fractals are generated? Fractals can be generated by repeating the same shape over and over, as shown in the following figure. Now, this is the first 0th generation. There is one triangle. Then, what we have did? This is the equilateral triangle. In the second figure, we again repeated this triangle by dividing it in between. So here, between each triangle, we have again divided in with different triangles. So we will get a star shape. In figure C, we can see we will again place in the middle of this particular equilateral triangle with two other more triangles. And we are repeating the same sequence again and again with each and every equilateral triangle to provide the second generation. Means now this first generation is equal to this particular part of the second generation. Means same figure we are getting again and again. We can repeat it in a number of times. So this is nothing but the fractal. This is the way we have to generate the fractals. Now, fractal is classified into three different types according to the property of self-similarity. It is self-similar. So that is exact self-similarity, Cauchy self-similarity and statistical self-similarity. Now, the exact self-similarity is the most commonly used. It is the strongest type of self-similarity and the fractal appears identical at different cells. As we have seen the case of equilateral triangle, it appears identical and it takes the shape of a snowflake. So it is a Koch snowflake or a Koch curve. Cauchy self-similarity, this is a loose form of self-similarity and the fractal appears approximately but not exactly identical at different scales. But it is somewhat identical. If you have seen it, it is not exactly but approximately similar. So this is a loose form of self-similarity. It contains small copies of entire fractal in a distorted or a regenerated form, as we have seen here. We will call it as a Mandelbrot set. Now third is the statistical self-similarity. This is the weakest type of self-similarity. The fractal has a numerical or statistical measure which is preserved across scales. To make fractal more realistic, a different type of self-similarity called statistical self-similarity is used. In this, each line is composed of smaller lines. As we have seen, there are a number of lines like this. If we zoom some part of the line, we will see this type of structure. Means each line is composed of smaller lines and the lines are random instead of being fixed. So this is nothing but the statistical self-similarity. Now we will see the mathematical fractal. If we divide a line segment into m parts, same parts, okay, which is having a same length, and each of which can be magnified by a factor of n to yield the original segments. Means suppose we break one line equally from middle, okay, which is, then we will have two equal lines. So two, we have two parts. If we join that part, we will get the original segment. In the same way, we consider a square or a triangle. By dividing it into the n square self-similar copies of itself, suppose a square will have four lines. If we divide that line and again join it, we will get a square. Means we are getting the original object. Self-similar, we can consider the cube here, which is composed of n square self-similar copies of the itself. If we magnify it, we will get a factor of n, means n number of segments we will get. If we join it, again we will get the original shape. So in short, we can say that if one takes a magnification n and raise it to the power of dimension d, then one will get the number of self-similar copies of the original object p. So that's why we can say that p is equals to n to the power d. Now by solving this equation, we can get d is equals to log p upon log n. This is the formula for the fractal dimension. Using this, we can create the different self-similar pieces of the object. Now using this formula of fractal dimension, we can calculate the fractal dimension of different objects. So we have considered here the line, square, cube, or any self-similar figure. For that, the dimension of line is 1. Okay, as we know, it is one-dimensional, square is two-dimensional, and cube is three-dimensional. And for any self-similar figure, we have considered it is having the d dimension, suppose. So the number of copies will be 2 is equals to 2 to the power 1. So it is having one dimension. So 2 to the power 1 is equals to 2. It is having two dimensions. So 2 to the power 2 is equals to 4. 2 cube is equals to 8 for cube. And for general object, that is any self-similar object D having the dimension D, we can write the formula P is equals to 2 to the power D, where we can consider any value for D. Now, the most common example of fractal is a Koch curve. So Koch curve is also called as a Koch snowflake or Koch island or a Koch star, which is a mathematical curve, and it is one of the earliest fractal curve which has been introduced. This Koch curve can be drawn by dividing a line segment into four equal parts. Okay, we will divide the line segment from here and then we will get four different segments. This is the first approximation of Koch curve. Now again, we divide this four line segments into two equal parts. Okay, now we divide this line segment in between. Okay, so we will again get the second approximation of Koch curve. Now this part, particular part, is similar to this part. Okay, now again, if we divide this, all these small line segments further, we will get the same shape as this. So that's why we will call it as a self-similar. This is the most important property of the fractal. So this is nothing but the Koch curve. So to apply the second approximation, we have to repeat the above process. So every time we have to repeat the same process to get the self-similar structure for further iterations. So we can note that each repetition increases the length of the curve by the factor 4 by 3. The length of the curve is infinite. It doesn't deviate much from its original shape, means we will have the original shape as we have seen. If we reduce the scale of the curve by 3, we find that the curve looks just like the original one, means it is self-similar. But we must assemble four such curves to make an original curve. We can make the original curve because it is self-similar. So for thus, we can say that 4 is equals to 3 to the power d. Solving for d, we get, if we want to solve this equation, that is for d, then we will get the value of d as 1.2618. Means the formula d is log 4 by log 3. If we solve it, the value of d will be 1.2618. Therefore, the Koch curve topological dimension is 1, but the fractal dimension is 1.2618. So this is the Koch curve. Now let's see some of the applications of the fractals. Fractal can be used to describe many highly irregular real world objects, that is cloud, mountain, trees, lightning, etc. But fractal can also be used for some other applications. For example, in the field of medicines also we can use it for the generation of music, for the generation of various art forms, for image compression, for cosmology, for creating some video games. So in different environment we can use this fractals nowadays. This is all about the fractals. Thank you.